Well, I have seen the recent Godzilla vs. Kong movie, and it was shockingly good. Well, unlike Batman vs. Superman, the movie which I hated as a kid. Well, for today's video, I'm going to be comparing that movie to Batman vs. Superman to prove that it is not a good DC movie. Oh, and spoiler warning, I don't recommend watching this video unless you've seen Godzilla vs. Kong, The New Empire. Thank you. Well, I don't really like the first movie that much. It was short pacing, and this movie just focused on King Kong and Godzilla fighting each other, and that is a less of a story. Well, I like the second movie way better. It has more action, an impacting story, and a character development on the monsters, which we've seen for the first time. Kong has been dealing with loneliness in the beginning, and you can literally tell by the body language. The story in Batman vs. Superman, it's nothing much really. It is just a really slow-paced movie that jumps into one plot to a totally different plot, which that does not have something to do with the movie. Well, Captain America Civil War is somewhat more interesting than what we got from Batman vs. Superman. The interaction between Superman and Batman is sort of interesting, like I care. The better story is easily Godzilla x Kong. Well, Godzilla and King Kong has a less of a rivalry in this movie because they just team up, so we can just pull that out of the way. Well, Batman and Superman rivalry was, well, excuse my language, BS. The fight scene in Batman vs. Superman was not that great. It has no impact. And Batman using Kryptonite against Superman wasn't really a shock. We just know that he's going to beat Superman with Kryptonite, and that is just lame. And kind of cheating too. Well, Superman wasn't so innocent either, because he was throwing around Batman the whole time before he uses Kryptonite. And that is a unfair fight. And I can literally predict that Batman and Superman are going to work together. I mean, tell me something new. And I have seen some wasted characters in that movie. You know Jimmy Olsen from the Superman comics? Well, guess what? He freaking died in the beginning. What a waste. Oh, and don't get me started with the fact that they wasted Superman too. I mean, believe me or not, Superman just couldn't catch a break in that movie. Well, first, he gets defeated by Batman, and then he gets injured in outer space. And oh, let's add Superman getting killed by Doomsday too. Like, I don't know why that pissed me off so much. A matter of fact that they just add the death of Superman storyline into the movie. Well, the first Godzilla vs. King Kong kind of did the same thing by adding the Mega Godzilla storyline. Well, Batman vs. Superman just forced the death of Superman storyline into the movie. Well, if Doomsday was not in a crossover movie, like Batman vs. Superman, just a Superman solo movie, then I would be fine with it. It makes it okay to put Doomsday in a Superman movie, but the Batman vs. Superman movie, not so good idea. Oh, and by the way, Wonder Woman showing up out of nowhere was predictable because they just literally spoiled that in the trailers. Well, I don't see any characters being wasted in Godzilla vs. Kong, New Empire. The action in the fight scenes are really cool, and it really stands up what a crossover movie should be. The action in Batman vs. Superman, well, whatever, dude. Okay, as a kid, I thought Batman vs. Superman was a decent movie, but watching this again as an adult, oh my gosh, man, this movie really blows down into crap. Well, you know, there are some better crossovers movie than Batman vs. Superman. Like Batman vs. the Ninja Turtles, Marvel vs. Capcom, and even Godzilla vs. Kong. Those make sense. The second Godzilla vs. King Kong was more of an improvement, and Batman vs. Superman is not. Say what you will about Batman vs. Superman, because this movie mostly deserves a 2.5 out of 10, and Godzilla X Kong gets a 6. Well, I would like to hear your opinion in the comments down below, and I see you in another time.